So the zero factor property is one method that you can use for solving quadratic equations. So you'll notice I have something very important written there, and it's all about the title. So when we're solving a quadratic equation using this strategy, I need both things from the title in my equation. I need one side of my equation to be all factors, right there. And factors means everybody's multiplying, nothing else. No plus sixes or plus sevens hanging off the end. And the other side of my equation has to be zero. Okay? So the zero factor property works when those two situations are satisfied. So here's our lead-in. If AB equals zero, and that's multiplying, everybody's a factor, there's my zero, then either A equals zero or B equals zero. It's the only way to multiply and get zero out. Okay? So what if it's 2x equals zero? So right there's our multiplying. So if 2 times x equals zero, then, right, my options are the 2 could be zero, but it's not, it's 2. Or the x could be 0. So that means x equals 0. So if 2 times something equals 0, the only way that can happen is if the x is 0. What about this one? 8 times x minus 7 equals 0? It's not the 8. It must be the x minus 7. So now we have just a little bit of work, and I'm sure you're doing that in your head, but here's how it looks if you do it out. The x minus 7 equals 0, the x that makes this part true, when you add that 7, is 7. So if I plug 7 in, I get a 0 here times 8, that's 0. Okay, one more step. What if this? I have x plus 5 times x plus 2 equals 0. Okay. The only way that can happen is one of those factors, either the x plus 5 is 0 or the x plus 2 equals 0. So x equals negative 5 would make that true because it makes this factor 0. This factor is something else, but I don't care because I'm multiplying it by 0, so that gets me to 0. Or if x is negative 2, then I can get one of my factors equal to 0. All right, well, obviously we're not going to get to have them look like this all the time. Instead, most of your job will be getting those quadratic equations factored, set up into that form where we have factors on one side and a zero on the other. So let's start with this top one, and hopefully I have things that factor. So x squared minus 3x minus 10 equals 0. So I need to multiply to 10, subtract to give 3. How about x minus 5 times x plus 2 equals 0? So now I have everybody multiplying on one side, a 0 on the other. So x minus 5 equals 0, or, and you don't have to write the or, just emphasizing, or x plus 2 is 0, so that means that x is 5, or x is negative 2. And you might want to check to see how solutions are requested. Some people will request they look like this. It's a set of two numbers, so we set brackets, list all the solutions inside. Some people will let you get away with this. Sometimes you can put commas between them and nothing else. So see what you need to do. Okay, next example, 2x squared plus 3x equals 5. So the first thing I said, right, we need a multiplying and a zero. So you get the zero first because the 5, when it moves over, will influence how we write the multiplying on the left. So subtract 5 to get your zero. And now I need to write that left side as a bunch of factors. Let's see, a positive 5x. And a minus 2 will get me that positive. There's my negative. So product equals 0, yay. So 2x plus 5 is 0, or x minus 1 is 0. Okay. If 2x plus 5 is 0, let's see. Subtract the 5, divide by the 2. So negative 5 halves, if we plug it in up there, right, will make a true equation. If we plug it in here, it makes a true equation. If If we plug it in here, it makes this factor 0. I see that. Doesn't matter what this factor is because I've got a 0 times it. Or x equals 1 is my second solution. Typically, quadratics are going to have our two solutions. Okay. So let's take a look at one more. So now I have, I'll squiggle there so you can tell, x times x minus 1 equals 6. So I need to get a 0, and I need to get rid of the parentheses. So I'll distribute the x, move the 6, so it's all set up equal to 0, and then we factor. Minus 3 and plus 2. X minus 3 times x plus 2 equals 0. So either x minus 3 is 0, or x plus 2 is 0. So x equals 3, or x equals negative 2. Okay, so that's how you use the zero factor property.